Hello friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video, I'll explain you about Oracle AP AR netting functionality. So before we proceed further, we need to understand what is AP AR netting. AP AR netting functionality allows you to net your payable invoice balances against your receivable invoice balances, especially for those parties who are both your customers and suppliers. In a real business world, there could be a lot of scenarios wherein a supplier who is providing goods and services to you, it could be a same person to whom you may be selling goods and services. So for whatever the goods and services which are sold by your supplier, you create your AP invoices, and for whatever the goods and services provided are sold by you to the same person, you create your AR invoice. So the same party will be created as a customer in AR and supplier in AP module. So in order to arrive at a net balance figure between what you owe the customer, what you owe the supplier, and what customer owes you, AP AR netting functionality will help you in arriving at that particular figure. So there are a couple of steps involved in setting up the AP AR netting functionality. First, we need to enable your internal bank account for netting purpose, and then you need to assign this particular bank account to a seeded receipt class AP AR netting, and then you need to create a netting agreement, and in the netting agreement you need to specify who is your supplier and who is your customer, and there are a couple of other things, and then that will be followed by creating of your netting batch. Now let's see how we can execute these steps in Oracle. The first step is enabling of a bank account for netting purpose. I already have a bank account. So let me go to cash management responsibility, cash management vision services, go to setup, banks, bank accounts, and then I'll try to bring up my bank account. So this is my bank account. Okay, now select this bank account and click on update account. Go to account controls and ensure this netting account, I had already enabled in this case, but you should ensure that this netting account should be set to yes. That's the first step. And second step is you need to go to account access, click on access, continue. You need to check this particular checkbox of default settlement account. So these two are mandatory in order to use this particular bank account for netting purpose. So that's the first step. And second step is we need to assign this particular bank account to seeded receipt class AP AR netting. So that can be done in AR module. Now navigate to receivables, vision services, setup, receipts, receipt classes, and then try to query for F11 AP AR netting, control F11. So this is the seeded receipt class. So under this particular seeded receipt class, click on bank accounts, assign your bank account. In this particular case, I had already done that. So you need to assign your bank account which is enabled for netting purpose. So that's the second step. This is the second step, and the third step is creating of netting agreement. Go to under receivables vision services responsibility receipts netting agreement. So that brings up this screen. Click on create agreement. So the operating unit is defaulted based on the responsibility, and give a meaningful netting agreement name. So I'll mention it as a vision services AP AR netting, and choose the bank account. This is the bank account. Select only past due receivable transaction. I'll say no, so that it will, even though whether it's past due or not, it will select all the outstanding AR invoices. Netting order rule, how do you want to net those invoices? So whether you want to go by due date most recent to oldest, or due date oldest to most recent, transaction date, amount ascending, amount descending. So preferably go by the default one, which is due date oldest to most recent. And then netting balance rule, again, whether you want to net always or net only when the payables is greater than receivables. So I want to always net whether payables is greater than receivables or not. I want to do a netting batch. So go for net always. And the last option is netting currency rule, whether you want to net within each currency or whether you want to net by the accounted currency, or whether you want to use a single currency. Again, use the default value, which is net within each currency. And then select all the different kind of payable invoices which you want to include under this particular netting agreement. So whether you want to include only standard invoices, then just select only standard. If you want to include standard invoices, debit memo, credit memo, everything, then add all those things. So I want to include everything. Standard invoices, debit memos, credit memos. There are only four values. So standard invoice, debit memo, credit memo, and mixed type invoices. These are the four. So I'm just adding all the four different kind of AP invoices. And as far as the AR is concerned, you need to select all the receivable transaction types. So there are so many different transaction types available. So for the time being, I'm just selecting only one transaction type, which is Consulting East. So you need to include all the concerned transaction types for different transaction classes. Consulting East. Now click on next. Now select who is your supplier. So I have a supplier by name ABC Holdings INC. I have the same party as my customer. So as per this particular netting agreement, so I'm asking the system to net all the transactions for this particular supplier and the corresponding customer. So I'm not selecting any specific bill to location or specific supplier site. If you select a specific supplier site or a specific bill to site, then the netting will be restricted to only the transaction which fall under the particular supplier site or customer site. Next, so review everything, and once you're happy with this, click on finish. So you can see a message, Vision Services APR netting has been created. So we have created a netting agreement. Now we need to create one AP invoice and one AR invoice, and let's see how system net those transactions. So within AR, I'll try to create one AR invoice and ensure that all these transactions are created with the due date immediate. Because it's not necessary that you need to create with a due date of immediate. When you are creating your netting batch, you have got an option to select the due date of the transaction. So for the time being, I'm creating this transaction with the due date as immediate. ABC Holdings immediate. So when I say immediate, it is due today itself. So I'll create a AR invoice for say $15,000. I don't want any tax calculation. Save this. Complete this. Okay, so I have one AR invoice for $15,000. I'd completed that. Now I'll try to create a AP invoice for the same party. Go to payables, Vision Services, invoices, entry invoices. Invoice date is today's date, and invoice amount say $10,000. And let me check the payment terms immediate. Okay. This is for $10,000. Go to distributions, enter the account code combination, so you can pick up any expense account. Save this. So from an AR perspective, you should ensure that the invoice is in a complete status. So similarly in AP, you should ensure that the invoice is in validated and approved status. I mean, if it is approval is required, it should be approved status. Validate, force approval. Okay, it is validated, manually approved. Now we have one AR invoice outstanding for $15,000 and one AP invoice outstanding for $10,000. So go to scheduled payments and check the due date 23rd March. Okay. Now try to create the netting batch from receivables responsibility. Navigate to receipts, netting batch. Okay, so click on create batch. So it is asking you to select the netting agreement whatever we have created. So netting agreement is Vision Services. If you can see message, if you do not enter a netting agreement, then system will try to create a batch for all the existing netting agreements. And what is the settlement date when you want to settle this netting batch? So I want to settle this today. And what is your netting batch name? So I'll just say Vision Services netting batch. And transaction due date. So if I select a transaction due date as today, then system will select only those invoices which are due on or before 23rd March 2018. Okay. And submit match without review, I'm saying no. So that means like whenever I'm submitting this netting batch, it will allow me to review before proceeding further. Click on submit. Okay. So you can see message netting batch, Vision Services netting batch was created. Query for that. You can say it is in created status. So you can also go to view request and check the concurrent request which got triggered. So there's a concurrent request, create netting batch. It is still in a pending status. Let's wait for this request to be completed. Yeah, it's completed. Now requery this. Okay, it is in selected status. And now click on update button and review the transactions. So receivable transaction, here you should be able to see $15,000 AR invoice. And under payable transaction, you should be able to see $10,000, and looks like there is some other open invoice also for $100, which is fine. Yeah. So totally two AP invoices and one AR invoices. And if you do not want a couple of transactions, so let us assume like if you do not want this particular transaction, you can just say click on remove. Yeah, remove. And if you want add anything, you can add. Okay, once you are happy with these things, click on submit. Again, let's check the concurrent request. Let's wait for the concurrent request to be completed. Taking a while. Okay, submit netting batch is completed and it has triggered settle netting batch. So you can go back here and you can requery this. So it has changed the status from selected to clearing. And let's wait for this particular request to be completed. And once this request is completed, you should be able to see the status as complete. And once the netting batch is in completed status, so you can go and check the corresponding AR invoice and AP invoice. So for AP invoice, the payment would have been completed, and for AR invoice, receipt would have been completed, so they will no longer be outstanding. Okay, so netting data extract is complete. Re-query this, you should be able to see status is in complete. Now click on view output. So here you can see this is your AP invoice for $10,000 and this is your AR invoice for $15,000. Now try to query for that AP invoice and double check if the payment is appearing there. Payables, vision services, invoices, query for invoice number. You can see amount paid is $10,000, view payments. So this is the payment which is created by your AP AR netting process. So you can see it type as netting. Similarly, go and check for the AR invoice. Transactions and what is our AR invoice number? This is the transaction number F11. Okay, see here you can see out of $15,000 for AR invoice, $10,000 is offset. Or like system has created the receipt of $10,000. The reason being $10,000 is the AP equal amount. So that means now this particular AR invoice is outstanding only for $5,000. So system has taken care of settling your AP and AR invoice, and it has tried to arrive at the net figure. So net figure is AR outstanding amount of $5,000. So in this case, you should receive $5,000 from the customer. You need not pay the supplier for the same party the $10,000 in AP, because system has taken care of making the payment of that $10,000 in AP using your AP AR netting functionality. Now, if you want to see the details of this particular receipt, actions, installments, activities, details, you can see this $10,000 is created using a receipt method AP AR netting. And if you want to see the accounting entries, tools, create accounting, I will go for draft accounting. Accounting is successful. So tools, view accounting. Okay, so for $10,000, you can see cash account, debit, receivable account, credit. Okay, so hang on. This is 1110, 1110. Yeah, cash account 10,000, 10,000, and cash account got 1111. Okay, so you can just ignore this line. Okay, just look for the first line and the last line. I know the reason why it is showing these extra lines, because like I did some kind of an SLA customized to test something else in this environment. Yeah, but the actual journal entry is cash account is debited for $10,000 and receivable account is created with $10,000, because you are reducing outstanding by $10,000, and in your AP your liability account will be debited by $10,000 and your cash account will be created by $10,000. So the net impact is cash account should not have any net impact. Here $10,000 is debited here and $10,000 is created in your AP. Okay, thank you. Thanks for watching my video. For interesting videos on Oracle Financials, please do subscribe to my channel, and please do not forget to click on bell button to get a notifications on the latest videos. Thank you.